Welcome to ShapesXR channel, you're with Tupper Wonghart. Today we will explore how to bring 3D models into the world of mixed reality using Apple Vision Pro and MetaQuest 3. First, let's discuss the wide range of the 3D programs that are available in the market, which has its own strength, such as Blender, Maya, 3D Max, Cinema 4D. These are the kind of programs that you use for animation. For the architecture planning, you can use SketchUp or Live Home 3D. If you want to know the tutorial for the Live Home 3D using the iPad to create your own house plan for the 3D model, please check the link up here for the details. Next, we have Spline for create 3D elements on the website, Victory and Adobe Substance for product design, and the last one is the Luma AI for 3D scanning. Yeah, it sounds like a bunch of programs, it's a lot of choices. Like, how to choose them then? Well, when choosing the program, consider the fact that the functionality, the ease of use, and the compatibility. The functionality, it's like if you're gonna make a house plan, then you should use the SketchUp or Live Home 3D. But if you would like to use the phone to capture the 3D objects around you, then use the Luma AI program. They have all kinds of possibility to export the file. For example, OBJ, STL, DAE, FBX, and USD. This is a lot of possibility for the file export, but when you focus on the platform that you would like to export the file, like for example, like Apple Vision Pro, they primarily support the file format USDC, which developed by Pixar Studios. They said USDC file is the smallest and the easily to transfer between Apple device. You can use the USDC file on iPad, iPhone, macOS, and Apple Vision Pro. So the USDC file is the main extension that people use on the Vision OS. Well, but if your 3D program cannot export the USDC directly, it's fine. You don't have to worry about that. You can use the Reality Converter to convert various 3D files formats into the USDC and open them on the Apple Vision Pro. For example, I just bring all the 3D OBJ files and then drag it into the Reality Composer and then choose to export and then airdrop into the Apple Vision Pro. Super simple. Yeah. Additionally, if you want to combine multiple 3D files and then create a presentation, adding some animation, interaction once you tap on the object, then make a sound, that's the program that you can use called Reality Composer, which be able to merge all the multiple model file and make arrangement for the animation, combine them into a single files and put into the Apple Vision Pro, which is really create the engaging experience more than just building the 3D model plane, right? For MetaQuest 3, the process is a little bit more complicated since the MetaQuest system doesn't directly support the 3D files like a Vision OS does. In this case, we need to put into two types of the possibility. The first one, if the files is not that big, which is good because you can upload into the third-party program. In this case, I would use ShapesXR to host the model file. You can register the folder with them and then synchronize the file from your computer. That is some limited. ShapesXR support PNG and JPG for image, OBJ for 3Ds, and GLB, GLTF, and that's it. With the maximum file size 20 megabytes per file. And to use ShapesXR, it's simple. You just download an app on the MetaQuest and then enter the code that you see on the headset into the website. After that, choose new space and select the option empty space. To see the environment around, you need to enable pass-through mode,
by flipping the left controller and then pointing the right controller to the eye icon. This will open the screen that shows surrounding areas. To import the 3D model, press the button on the upper right of the left controller, which just looks like 3D model in the mini size button. Then select asset import and library, and then choose the import. The file that we uploaded to the server will be synchronized and it show up on the list here. Use the right grip and grab by aiming the controller at the 3D model and then pull it out. Continue to hold the grip button, then move your thumb fingers to the knob and then slide to the right and hold it to increase stop the model size. Then place it anywhere and it will appear as a 3D for your eyes. You can grab the 3D model and move it around or walk around them. You can place multiple 3D models by repeating the same process. If you want to delete any model, just grab and throw it away while releasing the trigger button. You can grab the model and put into the face to see the model very close up or scale them to actual size. There you have it. This is how we can place the 3D models on a mixed reality world and manipulate them using the MetaQuest 3.
However, if your file exceeds 40 megabytes or it's too complex, you will need to use the Unity for rendering. While setting up Unity for MetaQuest 3 requires a lot of additional stuff to provide a powerful solution for bringing the large 3D models into the mixed reality environment. The things that you need to do, for example, like installing Unity, get the license for the hobbyist, install the MetaQuest SDK all-in-one, choose the target device, and then import the model, and then adding the grab interaction. And all this is like takes hours to do, but it's the most powerful and get the 3D models to display on the MetaQuest. Well, to help you find the best path for the project, I create the diagrams that you'll be able to track which would be the best choice based on the file size, complexity, and the device you are targeting. By following the step outline in a diagram, you can streamline your workflow and ensure the best possibility results. So bringing your own 3D files into the world of mixed reality using Apple Vision Pro and MetaQuest 3 is some sort of exciting and rewarding process. Once you see the model right in front of you blending with the surrounding environment, I think that's the most fantastic feeling. Especially if the model is made by you, you will see them differently from the 2D screen. In 2024 March, this is the easiest way that I could gathering all the information, but I believe in the future there would be so much more easier, the better options for you to upload the file and open the file inside the MetaQuest 3 and the Apple Vision Pro. It's just beginning of the technology, so I hope this video would be helpful. If you have any question, please comment below so I can answer one by one. And if there's a lot of people interested in the same topic or one particular question, I'll make a video specifically for that. Thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting. Thank you for subscribing and like this video. See you on the next one.